Just like the PBA, Chokesdobo 3x3 Pilipinas entered their own Calamb bubble located at Inspire Sports Academy in Calamba, Laguna to kick off their latest leg. To know more about the developments and the competition, we're joined by Nueva Ecija Rice Vanguard Jai Reyes and broadcaster Anton Rojas. From the Calamb bubble in Inspire Sports Academy in Laguna, Anton Rojas and Jai Reyes, thank you so much for joining us here on ANC. Jai, I just want to ask you first. Jai, I know that this was a long road coming. How did you personally prepare for this leg of Chokesdobo 3x3?
Well, this is a last-minute tournament for us dahil wala nga MPBL at that time. So during the whole lockdown, our players, dire-diretso lang talaga yung workouts. So we had home workouts. They had sent videos to our trainers to make sure they were doing it. And nung nagkaroon na ng 3x3, we just periodized the whole workouts according to the needs of the 3x3. Kasi it's a little bit different from 5-on-5, the energy systems and everything. So I think it's working right now. We haven't won one leg, pero we reached the semis in both. So I think given the first time we've joined the 3x3, I think that's a good sign.
Anton, can you tell us or can you tell the audience on how did it all come about, the process of entering the bubble? I know there were safety protocols were in play. That was really one of the top measures for this leg, Anton.
Well, I think it all starts with the brainchild of Coach Eric Altamirano. He was talking to me and he said that it was around May when he came up with the idea of coming up with a bubble for 3x3. So it was a lot of planning that had to come together. So obviously, we have the godfather of 3x3 basketball in the Philippines, Boss Ronald Mascarenhas. And then, of course, Globe came in. That's why UC powered by TM with the name of the tournament, Mr. Ernest Koo, the president and CEO of Globe Telecom Incorporated, and then, of course, Mr. Hans C. of SM, Inspire Sports Academy. So these three men joined forces to come up with this league. And it's been a blast here at Inspire Sports Academy. You mentioned the safety protocols. We have somebody from the GAB here, si Ma'am Cara Malyonga, making sure that everybody's following the safety protocols with the mist being sprayed on the shoes, on the clothes. Everybody has to walk around with a face mask and the face shield. Now, the players, Jai knows this. Everybody's well taken care of. Everybody's well fed. We have 5 meals a day. So this wouldn't have happened without the planning of Coach E and everybody from Chokesdobo, including, of course, Boss Melmac, who's in the background chatting with Juan and the rest of the guys. So it's really a total team effort. And without everybody coming together, this Calamb bubble wouldn't have been possible.
Jai, was it a big adjustment for you? You know, all of the safety protocols, everything that you have to go through, all the processes, but especially, you know, that you have to prioritize that to be able to not just follow the rules, but also for your safety.
Well, yes, especially in training, that's where we really felt the safety protocols. But then again, without those safety protocols, we can't restart sports and basketball. The biggest adjustment was training with limited number of people. Like at first, they're only allowed 5 players on the court plus 1 coach. So when we went inside the bubble, our scrimmages were kind of fast-paced dahil we have to prepare already for the coming legs. And the game days are just so, you know, one leg, one day apart. Big part of it is recovery. And given that you haven't played full contact basketball in like 7 or 8 months, it's really a big adjustment. But we're just so happy to be back.
Mm. Anton, for our viewers, maybe Jai also could chime in. Anton, the format of the games, what is it like? How is 2 weeks going to be spent right there in Laguna?
Okay, so there are a total of 12 teams. 58 players all in all are inside the Calamb bubble. So there are 4 legs and the grand finals, which will be taking place on October 30. So we were done. We're done with the first leg. And like Jai said, they made it to the semifinals. They played against the team that won in the preseason and in the first leg. The favorites, of course, Zamboanga Family's Brand Sardines. So you've got 12 teams divided into 4 pools. Okay, the top 2 teams from each pool will advance to the quarterfinals, which is a knockout stage from then on out. So semifinals, and then you reach the finals. So that's pretty much the format of the tournament. So there are four legs and then the grand final. So Jai is going to have to battle it out for four more game days.
Jai, is this something new to you, or does this remind you of any competition that you had maybe when you were in high school or in college representing the flag or anything, Jai?
You know, I've always wondered how the NBA players felt playing every other day, three times a week. So ganito pala yon. And here in 3x3, you have to play five times if you make it all the way to the championship. So multiple games in a day is not just one goal. So it's very tough. And a big part of this is really cardio and conditioning. So it's a different experience. Para siyang ano eh, parang Cobra Kai tournament eh, ganun eh. Sunod yung laban. So talagang battle of grit and ano, attrition, medyo bakbakan talaga.
Jai, can you expound more on the shift from 5-on-5 to 3x3? How did you adjust? Well, or how are you all adjusting?
Well, with 3x3, the game's a lot faster. Contrary to what other people think, na since it's not full court, medyo mabagal yung pace. If you compute the shot clock with the 10-minute time span of the game, there's more possessions in the 3x3 game. And 12 seconds lang kasi yung shot clock. Eh. So you really need to put up a shot right away and then defend right away. So walang time na medyo pag-inbound ng bola, medyo jogging-jogging muna, pacing-pacing. Dito talagang the transitions, they're so quick, they're so fast. So that's the biggest adjustment for us.
Now, let's talk about competition, Anton. We've seen us outside the bubble, we see so many highlights about the competition. Anton, from your perspective as a broadcaster, what have you observed so far?
I have observed that you can't play pretty boy basketball here in 3x3 Pilipinas. I mean, Jai knows this. They've battled it out. They actually kind of have a target on their backs. But I mean, sobrang nabilib ako kina Jai because Juan got hurt in their last game. So they were down to three men. And then Maclean Sabellina got ejected. So they were down to two men. It was just Jai and Gab Banal. And guess what? They won the game. They showed a lot of heart. And I think that's what 3x3 basketball in the Philippines is all about. I mean, we go back to the days where we were playing in the streets, you know, in slippers, playing very physical. And that's what we're seeing. And that's what I think we're trying to reintroduce to the Filipino sports fan. And I think Jai is enjoying what's happening here. And he's ready to go a couple more days.
Yeah, Jai, no, maganda yung sinabi niya doon about it reminds us of maybe street, the way we used to play when we were younger. But at the same time, maybe not all may realize that this is highly physical. Right? Want to get that from your perspective, Jai.
Well, coming from me, I'm the smallest guy here, probably the lightest guy. So I get exposed a lot in the post-ups and, you know, yung mga simpleng banggaan dyan. But then again, it's 3x3. A good thing is when I shoot from outside, that's 2 points. And the layup is only one. So I kind of try to make it back there with the two-point shot. And you just can't stop playing. You got to fight. That's what's nice about 3-on-3. Tatlo lang kayo eh. So kailangan ka talaga asahan eh. If you put on a bad show, bad performance, the team is really going to feel it. So you have to carry your own weight. So, and you know that's your responsibility to the team. And since the best players in 3x3 are here, it's really enjoyable. It's so fun to see everybody playing, competing again. And yeah, like what Anton said, I'm really really enjoying this. Sana ano lang, easy lang muna sila sa post-up sa akin.
Nababawian mo naman, Jai.
Jai, when it comes to strategy, right? In basketball, we have that philosophy that, you know, you let the player shoot outside compared, you know, let them take the lower percentage shot, which is the outside. But then you mentioned na kapag makadoss ka, that's 2 points, but the layup is only one. Does strategy also have those adjustments, or does it also change when it comes to 3x3?
Yes, it's very different. If you watch the top team, the Zamboanga team, that's what they do. They try to avoid fouls because if you get into penalty in 3x3, that's two free throws right away. So that's kind of big. And then if you reach 10 fouls, that's two free throws plus ball possession. So fouls, the penalty situation, you really have to avoid that. If you watch them play, sometimes they really give up the layup so they can sprint out on the 2-point line to shoot that two ball because, you know, in the regular game, the difference between a 2 and a 3 is just 1 point. But here, it's double, a 1 point and a 2 point shot. So the strategy is very, very different. Of course, if you can make a lot of twos, go for it. Pero kung meron naman libreng layup and a mismatch underneath, you also have to take it. So it's a nice balance talaga. Depends on the style of play of your team, who your players are. Kami personally, our team, medyo maliit. So makulit kami maglaro. That's why medyo scrappy yung mga games na nakikita nyo sa amin. And we shoot a lot of two balls, so that's our style today.
Now, Anton, besides Jai, we see there in the background, Tonino Gonzaga, Juan Gomez de Leon, some of the key names that played in the UAAP, and also with the landscape of the MPBL still not resuming their season, some of the players shifted to this league. So who are the other players? Who are some of the guys we should watch out for, you know, in this leg of 3x3?
I think you got to watch out for the top team. Obviously, Zamboanga Family's Brand Sardines. You have Josh Monzon, who is the number one ranked 3x3 basketball player in the country. You have Troy Reich, like Jai mentioned. Alvin Pasaol. I did not know Alvin had an on switch when it comes to defense. We all know what he can do when it comes to offense, but you should have saw him in the finals of the first leg playing D. Grabe. So, sobrang intense. Nakadikit talaga. Hindi makatira yung offensive player. And then, of course, you have Santi Santillan, who's very good. A smooth operator in the paint. Uling Roasters, they have Carl Dehesa. They have Frankie Johnson. That team is one of the teams to watch out for. They have some sort of a rivalry with the team of Alvin Pasaol. But I think Jai and Nueva Ecija, they want to crash that party. Oh, by the way, Christian Luanzon is here. Just he's my roommate, Christian Luanzon. This is life in the Calam bubble. So Jai is having lunch with his teammates in the lunch hall. I'm here in my room. But like I said, Migs, earlier, everything is well taken care of. The gym is right outside. So every day we just walk to the gym. And I watch guys like Jai put in work every single day.
Now, we saw it also in the highlights that Juan, he's in the background. He sprained his ankle. Is he still going to be able to play if he's not able to play anymore? What happens to the team, Jai? What happens to the lineup?
The good thing is he's not going to leave the bubble. He's going to stay here. And he's getting treatment 24/7. Good thing we brought the PT for our team. So we'll see how it goes. If the swelling goes down and he can tolerate the pain, sana. I just really hope for the best that he can play kahit sa Grand Finals, the fifth leg on the 30th.
Mm. Now, Jai and Anton, let's talk about the impact of 3x3 now going pro. And finally, it has materialized, right? Now, of course, it was there, but then now it's more magnified because of competition. It's very limited right now in the Philippines. But how do you think now this one will be able to transcend to new heights, especially that the competition is tougher now?
I think being a pro, it carries a lot of responsibilities, especially the first three pro 3x3 league here in the country. The players welcome it. You know, it's good for their credentials also. And the level of play, for sure, mas maraming players nasasali dahil pro na nga itong 3x3. And we look forward to the future for 3x3 to grow because this is the purest form of basketball. And, you know, everybody in the Philippines can see that meron ng pro. And the 3x3 career is a possibility for everybody.
I think this opens a lot of doors for basketball players who are graduating from college and choosing the path. Where are they going to go? Are they going to go 5-on-5? Are they going to go 3x3? Because now this seems like a very viable option, especially with the prizes that are being given out by Boss Ronald Mascarenhas. I mean, you have a grand prize of 1 million pesos, and in the leg, you have a grand prize of 100,000 pesos. Uling Roasters with Chico Lanete, who was a longtime 5-on-5 veteran, his team won 100,000 pesos for being second place. And that's only because Boss Ronald wants to give the national team a hard time. So even if you just make it to second place, you win that amount of money. So that's an exciting incentive for any person who wants to pursue a career in basketball. So I think this is a new path for any person who wants to pursue a career in basketball. 3x3, I mean, it's just as exciting as 5-on-5. Some might even say more exciting, especially with the games that we've been seeing so far in this tournament.
Now, Jai, it's not just the incentives. It's not budget, not just the excitement, but also that long-term goal, not just by playing for club teams, but also representing the flag, right, in international competitions. How do you think that the Filipino players are maybe in par, you know, with the international competitions?
We see the 3x3 is really popular in Europe. It's really big there. A lot of people have made it their careers, even if they don't have like a monthly salary from a team, like the normal setup, just because of the cash prizes, like what Anton said, they're able to live off that already and make it a full-time career just playing 3x3 basketball. So I think for the Philippines, given this time, it creates a lot of opportunities for young kids to set a goal and to aspire for something instead of doing other things. So I really have high hopes for the country in terms of 3x3. I think we really can perform well because of the scoring system wherein you hit a lot of twos. You can really negate the height disadvantage that we have against the other countries. So I'm really excited for 3x3 in the Philippines.
And Mix, just to add to what Jai said, yeah, because the big picture for Boss Ronald Mascarenhas is to one day see Philippine basketball in the Olympics. So that's what this 3x3 tournament is all about, to develop these players to one day be able to compete on the international stage in the Olympics. Because as we know, 3x3 is now an Olympic sport.
Now, Jai, just for the ones at home, there are so many online camps, kids from all ages are working on their game, in a competition right now. If they want to pursue something, a career out of 3x3, what should they do first at home or practice at home?
Well, the most important thing, not just in 3x3, but in any other sport, is your body, your physical abilities, what you can do, how you can move. So I think the conditioning part is the base of every sport. Cardio and getting your strength up, because it's all about absorbing forces on the court. If you get your body strong enough and healthy enough to do that, it's a big advantage already. And you know, with social media right now and online videos, it tends to be negated, wherein the things on top are the ones getting focused, the highlights, the ankle breakers. But when you see the NBA players, there's no way they can do it if they're not in great shape. You see LeBron James, 17 years in the league. His base, his foundation really is making himself in the best shape possible. So I think that's my best tip for kids out there, is to start from the foundation and the base, which is your conditioning. You know, there's a lot of coaches out there that you can hire, and so you can be on top of that. So I think that's a really big investment if you're talking to parents also.
Anton, you want to add?
I think Jai is right, because I mean, you have guys as young as Juan Gomez de Leano, who's 20 years old. Imagine that, 20 years old, competing in this type of tournament. And you have Chico
look
Lanete.
At those biceps.
Yeah. and then you have grizzled veterans like Chico Lanete. I'm not going to say how old Kuya Chico is, but we know he's been playing 5-on-5 basketball for a very long time. Yet here he is, still in shape, nakikisabayan sa mga bata. So Jai is 100% correct about taking care of your body to be able to compete in a highly physical type of competition such as 3x3 basketball.
Lastly, Jai, whoever wins this leg, what do you think will be the biggest win of a Chuksugo 3x3?
No doubt, the biggest win is for being a part on the restart of sports. That's the biggest win. Because, you know, no matter who wins the legs, the grand finals, it doesn't matter. The most important thing is that we're seeing that this can be done by all the other leagues in these times. So I think that's the biggest win, not just for us, for the viewers, but for the whole country.
All right, so there you have it, Jai Reyes and Anton Rojas. Thank you so much. Stay safe inside the Kalam Bubble.